I've built just about every single thing that walks, crawls, runs, or flies on this show, and yet I still haven't built a monster truck. Well, Round 2 sent over their Coca-Cola monster truck in 1/25th scale. It's based off the USA 1 kit from days of old, now with the new Coke livery on there. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. First, we'll get the big old Chevy 1500 body out there with its interior tub, and I love the sound of new styrene falling all over the desk. You can see this is molded in a slightly off-white. We can really catch the details in that. It is a sharp-looking sport interior, the same interior and cab they would have used on the 454 SS Chevy models that AMT used to release. And I sure wish that one would come back with the short box, because I love that truck and have a personal connection to it. Two of my friends owned them. So this is that beautifully done Chevy Silverado cab. Long box on this one. See the detail in there. The cab and the body lock together, make the job real easy for you to line those up together. You can see the underneath is smooth because the underneath and the under cab detail is covered in a large one-piece chassis, which will help hold the monster truck rigid. We got a lot of stuff hanging off there and some heavy wheels and tires, so this is actually a bonus, a beneficial thing to have done. Check out that wheel and package on there. We're going to have inserts that go inside for extra detailing. Big set of wheels on that. Of course, there is no stock option in this kit. It's a monster truck. Check out the 16 shocks. Beautifully detailed all together with their shock shafts. We can get those painted. Detail those shock shafts. We got multiple drive shafts to get all the power down to the ground. All the different angles, the severe angles those things have to run. We've got our hood. We've got some engine parts. Check out that driveline with the agricultural axles on there, heavy duty. Massive track bars, brush guard, complete option on there. We've got either half to our blown V8. Stock air cleaner, belt and pulley system, manifolds, because of course they're going to be reusing this from the other Silverado parts. We got our transfer case, cross member, we even got a spare tire in there. So save those parts if you want for other Chevy builds. We got our stock dashboard, those GM bucket seats from the early 90s. Everybody knows this dashboard with the green radios, that Chevy steering wheel. We got our tailgate on there. We got our hood, which has been pre-cut open for that blower. Massive leaf springs, fender flares, inner wheels, huge size of those things. We got a step bumper with diamond plate. That's awesome. We got our light bar there. Excellent detail. On this side, we've got another transfer case. We've got our springs. Check out the arch on those leaf springs, the size of them. Excellent detail. The molds have held up well. They must have printed a million of these things back in the day. Everybody loved those Silverados. Check out the size of those agricultural tires, labeled A and B, so you know which sides to put them on, because they are directional. There is no brand name on those monsters. You don't really need them. It's pretty awesome looking, though you could get some giant decals to put on there if you want. I know plenty of places carry those decals. We'll get those big tangerines out of the way. We got the new Coke decal set. You can see the large side. We've got this nice bubble fizz pattern to replicate the box art across there. Make your masking a little easier to paint it up. We've got Chevy emblems, we've got 1500 emblems, we've got dash gauges. Excellent. What else we got? We got chrome. We got all the parts to our light bar. We've got our huge front bumper. We've got beautifully molded headers in chrome. We got blower parts, belt drives, carburation. All that on that tree. And on this tree, we've got those wheel inners. Aren't those nice? You can just push those down in, or you can paint them an accenting color. Do anything you want. We got that ubiquitous Chevy grill from the 90s when they changed over their design from the square body. We've got lights, fog lights, belt drives, valve covers, all kinds. We got mirrors on there if you wanted them. Nice. Nice looking chrome on there, nice and thick. And the last parts in the kit, red tail lights, lights for all the light bars. We've got our windshield and back glass, which is one piece, which makes it easy to slide in. So that's that. That's everything in the huge monster truck kit. A lot of stuff in this one because it's a big, big kit. I mean, look at the size of my hand. Twice the size of a normal model box. I'm going to start building. We'll be right back. I haven't built up a monster truck kit since I was a kid, and I forgot just how fun and easy they are with these nice AMT monster truck kits with those solid leaves. It makes it a really simple project. Now, you're going to see I left a lot of stuff on the tree so I can paint it individually, like these trailing arms and the brush guard. I don't know if I'm going to use the brush guard or not. It will go on there, so I just decided to hold on to it, get it painted, and then I can decide later because you can always change your mind. I want to paint the drive shaft separately. They'll be a little more difficult to put into the drive line after the fact, but we can gently bend them and tweak them into place and they will fit fine. So I want to get those painted separately just for some accents. I want to get the master cylinder painted separately, so I glued that together and we have that separate from the firewall. The interior tub, of course, will want to be painted separately. The wheels, I glued them together. These tires are so soft that you can easily push those over the wheels when we get to that point. We're not going to have a problem. So those you can glue together, make sure that they hold solid. We're putting in that chrome insert in the center, or you could paint it another color. So the wheels themselves, I will paint a nice accent color to the vehicle and get those ready to go on their own. The interior parts here, all one thing, because on the Chevys, the seats and the dash and the steering wheel were usually the same color as the rest of the interior. They were all tinted the same. At least all the Chevys I were in, if it had a gray seats, it had a gray dashboard. If it had red seats, it had a red dashboard, black seats, so on and so forth. So that's what I like. That's what I remember. That's how I'm going to do it. And I rode in a million of them like a lot of you had. The blown V8, I did assemble some of the chrome parts on. The blower house, the blower base there, the front cover for the engine, all that stuff is all glued into place. I will be painting that a nice metallic color, like a modified engine that they didn't bother painting at all. Just a nice shiny raw metal. And those I wanted on there. Now, for the blower itself, I just glued the pulley housing on the front of it, and I will get that painted up on its own in another color. For the carburation, I will do exactly the same. Super glued those together. Then I will get those spray painted a different tone of metal and get those on the vehicle just because I like those accents. The belt and pulleys, I'm going to be spraying these all black. Then I will go in and detail the pulleys individually instead of the other way around. So I've got that cut off its own little tree. The hood, of course, will be its own color. So that's ready to go. The shocks, I definitely want to paint those off the truck. Completely different color than the vehicle, so you really draw attention to them. 16 shocks on there, 4 on each side like that of each axle. So I definitely want to do those separate. And I'm going to be painting those up and then detailing them by hand. Check that out. I got it all pushed together, test fit. That body locks to that bed. Super nice. I'm not even going to glue those together. I've put the firewall in, because it just goes up flat and I want to get that all painted with it. We'll see how the body goes on so easy. We just push forward till those tabs in the back come loose. And then we'll just unsnap it and bring it out. And look, that's not glued together. You can hear it, but it's holding together beautifully. So I'm not even going to bother clipping it on. If I need to make any adjustments, I will. But then I'll be able to get this body painted its base color, then masked. I love the box art with those decals, so I'm going to try to emulate that somewhat when I do my build. So that is all set to go just the way it is. The chassis I want to do in a different color than the rest of the truck. So we've got our axles glued on there. You can see all those mount. Make sure when you line up your springs, you do long side towards the back for the front axle, long side towards the front for the back axle, so that you have your proper, see how it sits in the center of the wheel well. We want to make sure that we don't have wheels too far forward or too far back. Transfer case is in, cross brace. The engine will drop in from the top. There's no worries about that. So go ahead and detail it, or you could just loosely glue the suspension together and pull it off and paint this differently. But I'm going to paint this as one large slug, a nice accenting color to the vehicle. It is a custom off-road truck. You can design it as you wish. So we're going to head over. We're going to start slinging paint as always. We'll be right back. It actually doesn't take a lot of work to get one of these monster kits of this vintage all together. It's really simple and it looks awesome, just detailed enough. And of course the super dealers can go in and put travel straps in it and all that kind of stuff, but it looks excellent the way it is. The only real thing I did on the chassis that wasn't on camera was that I took some dark gunmetal metallic craft paint and dry brushed the chassis just to enhance the high areas, which also of course accentuates the low areas. And then I just super glued everything into place. The arms, the drive shafts, the shocks look great. If you paint them up, you can paint them any color you want. Match the truck, make them look your own. I wanted bright yellow, so they stood out real strong. And those just push into place. I actually don't have any glue holding the shocks in. Pushed them through their carriers on the axles, the shock mounts, and then they just lined up with the upper shock mounts. I didn't use any super glue at all. The trailing arms, I did use super glue on to hold those into place, but everything mounts in beautifully. And then I super glued the engine in, and the drive shafts just all friction fit in between the axles and the transfer cases and the little mini drive shaft from the engine to the transfer case. So that all looks excellent. You can see the engine on there with its detail. Did some black washing of the valve covers in between the carburetors on top. Just need to install the little air cleaners. I painted the bottom of the air cleaners with some ivory white craft paint. Get those together on there. But this is a much more simple build than I thought it would be when I started. It's actually just crazy simple and nicely detailed, even though it is simple. Sometimes you get the best of both worlds. The interior looks great. Looks every bit period 1990s Chevrolet. Got our dash decals in there. Got the detail with the metallic gel pens. I've shown those on a bajillion reviews. They're just gel pens. You get them in packages of any color from any craft store. And I painted in the green, the General Motors green, the General Motors gold for that optional CD player that they stuck a half mile away, because they only have this tiny little digital radio on the dashboard in the actual cockpit instrument cluster. If you wanted a CD player, they stuck it way over on the side there. It was not convenient at all unless you had your girlfriend sitting over there and changing it for you. I remember that design quite well. I took a look and there were no red steering wheels in any of the Chevys, so I made sure to paint that black so that it looks the right way. The dash decals look lovely and that looks awesome. And we've got the rest of our interior all in the red. The only actual darker areas were those little sections on the door panels there, so I hand painted those. We got our nice cup holder and console with the bucket seats. That's going to look nice with the red theme, and it's a lot darker so it doesn't match the exterior, and there's a nice little darker interior accent. We got the wheel and tire package together. They just press fit together. Make sure you follow your A and B side on the tires so that they are directional when you install them, so that when you get done, you have two left and two right side tires. Did a little bit of sanding on the tread. Still like them a little shiny. I want this to be a new monster truck. Got our chrome accents on the inside. Of course, you could have painted those, but I like them like that with the red wheels. Looks extensively like a nice shiny new monster truck. Still have to glue in place the headers. If you wanted to do used chrome headers, Tamiya orange clear, Tamiya clear blue, you paint that on the bends of the headers. You can have yourself some very nice temperature changed chrome on those headers, a little burnished chrome on there. We got our front bumper insert with the diamond plate, which will go just above our front bumper, which I use some Tamiya clear orange for. Black washed inside the winch. Those will get together like so and go underneath that front grill. We'll get the body out here. Now I did glue the roll bar on with the lights, but I don't have it glued into the truck. You'll see a little bit of cloudiness in here. It'll take a few hours for that Mod Podge sealed inside there to dry all the way, and then that'll be crystal clear. But on the build here, since I go so fast, they haven't dried all the way. You can see how clear it is underneath the body there, and you can't see it through the glass. That's what those lights will look like. But we got our grill going on with our blackouts. We got our side marker lights done in Tamiya clear orange. We got our master cylinder glued in. I'm not going to paint anything underneath the hood different except for that white. I like it. There's no radiator in this truck, so it's all a custom truck. And we've got our custom paint. I painted in black where the door handles are. I did black stripes for the slider, pushed our bumper in, pushed our tail lights in, and painted black on the tailgate there. All the rest will be decal work on this truck, and it's going to look phenomenal. I may even attach the mirrors, even though it is a monster truck. I might attach them, depends on how I feel. That's why I've left them on the tree, and we'll just wait and see. Got those air cleaners. Got the hood ready to go. That just drops right into place. We'll give everything a few coats of clear when we're done. After I put the decals on, I'm going to go ahead and push everything together. It's a friction fit at this point, except for the headers, which will require some glue. And we will be back for that final. Another Coca-Cola kit all said and done, sent over by Round 2. This kit is out right now, and it is available. I will link down in the description where you can snag this from Auto World and Model Roundup. What I used to get these decals on there, they all laid down real nice. No ripping. You can see all those fender decals went around there, followed that paint line, and covered up my little jagged edge and made it look so sweet. Doing that sweeping line around the back, got that awesome Chevrolet tag across the back. Remember, they also had just the regular silhouetted Chevrolet emblems on the decal sheet in white there. Just the standard Chevy emblems. So you can get the lettering if you didn't want that full stripe, but on the red back, it looks beautiful. Got everything to glue on. This truck went together super, super easy. There were no fit issues whatsoever. The body just pops right down and slides in like I showed you. So I could easily recommend this monster truck for a first model kit back. We'll just shove them right off the table. I could easily recommend it for a first model kit back because it goes together so easily. There's no fit issues. There's no fighting with it. There's nothing. Everything just pushes together, and you can use super glue on the chrome parts. When you use super glue on chrome parts, if they fog a little bit, just brush on some future floor polish and it gets rid of that fogging. To get the decals to settle down, and they settled down beautifully, all I did was wipe on some Tamiya Mark Fit. Model Roundup keeps this in stock. It works really well. Mark Fit, they also make a Mark Fit Strong. You can use either one. You use the Strong if they're really complicated decals, or you can use the regular, but if you just get the Strong for everything, it'll be fine. But you can see it gets the soak down into the sides. Those decals are well done. They're thin, so they do sink right into the body moldings. They don't give you any fights or anything. I did use the mirrors just because they're one piece and they're so well done with their little triangle mount like a pickup truck would have from GM back then. And they went on so easily. They're the nice chrome of the light bar and the bumpers and everything. So I used them. That grill definitely is done right for a Chevy with the side markers and the inserts and the bow tie logo. The interior is spot on. I've been in enough Chevys. This interior was from the AMT 454 SS model, and it definitely fits right in there with the bucket seats, the red interior. My buddy had a 454 SS in black with that red velvety interior. It was exactly what it looked like. I even sent him a picture of this when I got done with it and said, doesn't this thing look familiar to you? Love that blown V8 with the carbs and the blower and the air cleaner sticking out the hood. You can see the hood fits nice. The wheels and tires fit, and on this one, they just pop on, so the truck still rolls, but there's enough friction that it won't just go flying off a shelf either. Those wheels are gorgeous underneath. The underbody is sweet with those big shocks. You can see them all the way around, and those just press fit into place. Sanding the tires just gives them a little bit less of a toy appearance, makes them look like real rubber, and that's what I like on there. I use the Coke license plate. Overall, extremely easy build. I cut the Coke decals at the box and slid them back so you'd have that nice gap instead of making it cover the whole thing. I wanted it to look like a real monster truck someone had built out of an old Chevy body and jacked it up on massive Leafs and military axles, and he's taking it out to have some fun with it with his local Coke sponsorship. So thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks to Round 2. I will put links down in the description to pick this up. As always, build your kits for you. You can go online and find any kind of sponsor decals for these trucks and build up whatever you want. You can get it with the Coke logos, or you don't have to use those Coke logos, and you can build it up any way you want. Remember, it's got the 1500 logos, the Silverado logos, the bow tie, the Chevy on the back. You're all set to go with any design you want to use. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.